We begin with the post-Soho ferry disaster. More than 3 weeks have passed since the ferry capsized off the southwestern coast of Korea, and over 30 passengers still remain missing. For more on the updates on that, our Kim Ji-yeon joins us live from the news center. Now, Ji-yeon, what are we learning of late?
Well, the ferry's operator will no longer be allowed to do business. The Ministry of Oceans and Fisheries says it will revoke the business license of the Cheonghaejin Marine Company today. And the ministry did say earlier that it would start the process after formal investigations proceeded against the ferry operator. But in light of recent developments that demonstrate negligence on the part of the captain and crew members, it's clear the ministry is not going to wait.
Right. Speaking of investigations, Ji-yeon, the representative of the ferry operator, Kim An-sik, was arrested earlier this morning. He was charged on what?
Well, the CEO of the Cheonghaejin Marine Company, Kim An-sik, was arrested on multiple charges that include negligent homicide. The prosecutors are trying to prove that the ferry operator had knowledge of the vessel's problems beforehand but continued to transport passengers and cargo for the sake of profits. The investigative team says that the overloading of cargo on the Soho ferry would not have been possible without the approval of the ferry operator's CEO. And through the investigation into Kim, prosecutors are also trying to close in on the de facto owner of the ferry operator, Yoo Byung-hun, for business irregularities that may have contributed to the ferry sinking. But the investigators are having a tough time getting close to those who are closest to you to show up for questioning. One of his sons, who has permanent residency in the United States, failed to appear for the third time today. So the prosecutors are seeking to force him into the country with the help of the FBI.
All right, let's shift our focus to the search efforts. There have been no additional bodies found for the past 24 hours because of the bad weather conditions down in Jindo. Any development in there?
Well, Konyo, operations were temporarily suspended due to strong currents, and it's getting dangerous for all of those involved, with search efforts continuing around the clock. There are rising number of injuries among volunteers and officers participating. More than 20 divers have been taken to a nearby hospital after showing symptoms of decompression sickness, a diver's disease that includes acute pain in their bodies. And the Coast Guard official that was found unconscious yesterday is fortunately doing better today after undergoing surgery. More medical staff have been deployed to the scene since the civilian diver died earlier this week, but there's criticism that there needs to be more adequate measures to ensure the safety of the civilian search divers there.
All right, that was Arirang News. Kim Ji-yeon with the latest updates on the Soho ferry disaster. Thank you.